Hello everybody, I'm back here with international master Krishna Teja, who has performed exceptionally well in the sixth round of the Sunway Sitges International Chess Festival here today. He has just beaten Vincent Keymer in an extraordinarily exceptional game. Krishna, without much ado, why don't you walk the viewers through your fabulous game?
Yeah, today I played with white pieces. I played Nf3, d5, d4, nf6, c4, e6, nc3, c5, cd5 and d5. I didn't expect he will play semi-tarash with me, as he's playing Nimzo Indian, Slav and these defenses. Okay, knight and d5, e4, knight into c3, b into c3, cd4, cd4, bishop b4 and d2. Bishop d2, bishop into d2, queen into d2, castling bishop c4. Yeah, till here everyone knows it's just developing moves. Then he played knight d7, castling b6, here I played d5, then he played knight f6 and queen f4. Till here it's my preparation. Okay, I know if he played e d5, I should play rook a d1 and it's fine, either it's equal or just less equals. Okay, he played e into d5, then rook a d1, bishop b7, e into d5, rook c8. Here I calculated for some time and played d6. Okay, I have a pass up pawn, so I should advance it. He played bishop into f3. Yeah, I should play g into f3, and I thought it's fine, because even if my king is not so safe, his pieces are not active, so it's okay, we can just weaken our king, it's fine. So g into f3, he played knight h5, queen g4 is forced, because if I play queen d4 or something, he'll play queen g5 check. So queen g4, rook c5. Then okay, idea is rook g5, so king h1. Then again he played knight f6. Here I have, I think, 2 to 3 moves: queen h4, queen f4, and queen d4. Queen h4 is not good. I don't know why, I felt a bit uncomfortable with the move. Okay, queen d4. He's playing queen a8, attacking the f3 pawn. After rook d3, then rook d8. I don't want to give him tempo and with queen a8 and then rook d8. So I played queen f4, already defending my f3 pawn. So if he play moves like queen a8, I can just push my d pawn. So after queen f4, he played queen c8. Here, I need to take a decision. I have a choice like rook d4, bishop moves to somewhere, and counterattack move rook g1. I felt rook g1 is better if it works. Okay, so I calculate for some time. After rook g1, he can't play rook into c4 because of queen into f6, g6 and d7. It's clearly better. Even without d7, just play rook g1 and rook e7. Anything is fine. So after rook g1, he has, I think, two choices. One is knight h5 and other is rook f5. Knight h5, I can play either queen. I'm going to play queen h4, because queen h6 is not so great. Just he'll play some move like king h8. So I'm going to play queen h4. And it's like fine for me. My next idea is to play d7. If he plays queen f5, then I think I'll play bishop e2, followed by d7. So it's fine. That will happen. After rook g1, he played rook f5. I think it's a blunder. It's just clearly winning. I think within 1 or 2 moves, I played 1 or 2 minutes, I just played queen h6. Knight h5 is not possible because of rook into g7, knight into g7, and rook g1. So after queen h6, he should play g6 and d7. It's over. Wherever he moves, okay, let's say knight into d7, rook into g6, h into g6, queen into h6, queen into g6, king h8, queen h6, king g8, rook g1 mate. If he plays moves like queen c7, I can just at least take queen into f8 and d8 queen. It's rook up. If he play queen d8, it's rook into g6, h into g6, queen into g6, king h8, and I think, yeah, queen into f5, it's over. Rook d4, rook h4 mate. So it's over. After d7, he resigned.
Sure. So a couple of questions. Till what point in the game were you like in your opening preparation?
It's like till queen f4, I know exactly, it's fine. But okay, for openings like semi-tarash, I don't think everyone will prepare till the end. Okay, you just need to prepare till what point you're getting decent position.
So you did mention that you weren't expecting him to play semi-tarash.
Semi-tarash, because okay, when you have choice like choice of opponents like Nimzo Indian Slav, he's playing Nimzo Indian Slav, Queen's Gambit decline, I think A6 Slav, lot of openings. Semi-turn rush, you can just equalize without even without knowing. Yeah, it's a very good line from Black, but if you're playing with low rated, I don't think it's a great choice.
But you were still prepared for it.
Not today, but okay. I know D5 is the move. When I played D5, till D5 it's normal moves. Okay, when I played D5, I know. Yeah, D5 for knight C5, I think I should play something like rook D1. For knight F6, I should play queen F4. I know these two things.
Okay. Yeah. And one very important question. Yeah. How did you come up with queen H6?
Queen H6. Okay, you should calculate it when you are playing rook G1. So, after rook g1, yeah, of course, first thing, he can't play rook into c4 because of queen into f6 is clearly better. You should calculate rook f8, knight h5, okay, calculate these things. So, okay, I took some 10 minutes, something like that. Okay, if he plays knight h5, queen h4 is better, and if he plays rook f5 and queen h6 is like clearly winning. I didn't expect he'd play rook f5 actually.
Okay. Yeah. Great. What a fabulous game, Krishna. Seriously, very exciting chess. Even yesterday was a roller coaster of a game when you were playing against Grandmaster Maxime Lagarde. You drew against him.
Yes.
But you have to tell us what happened there.
Yeah, okay. Yesterday is my worst game in this tournament, first of all. From starting till some point, I played very decently. But when I started to get advantage, things messed up. Okay, I won a pawn, then he gave one more pawn and one more pawn. I am 3 pawns up at some point. But the thing is, I couldn't find win. I mean, I am unable to find win there. I am really irritated what's happening when you have 3 pawns up in ending and still you're unable to find win. So I just played some moves without any idea. I actually underestimated his position. After he recaptured, I think, one or two more pawns, he started pushing his pawn. Then I need to take the pawn with my knight, and from there he played really well. He's like rook bishop and I have rook 2 pawns. He played really well and he just took both of the pawns and he played well, and he got winning position in that. And the lucky thing is, when he found the mate, and it's the 50th move finished. Yeah.
Yeah, so basically, you know, those that were following your game were saying, oh wow, it's mate in 13.
Yeah.
Oh no, it's mate in 10.
Yeah.
And it's a theoretical draw position, but somehow he managed
to... it's like 6 hours game. In the last hour, we both are like just playing...
Exhausted. Absolutely. Do you think that he knew that it's going to still be a draw in spite of finding the win? Both of you were calculating the 50 moves?
Yeah. No, he. I don't know whether he is checking, but I'm checking from move 10 and 15, 15, 20, 25, like that, I'm just counting.
Okay.
But by the 35th move, he started to get good position. I mean, he's getting advantage. And I was like, there are 15 more moves, I thought I'm losing. Exactly around 42nd move, he got the mating plan. But he's in 1 minute and I have some 3 minutes. I'm lucky that he didn't find that way.
Yeah, this is luck to another level.
Yeah, and he saw that plan when he's in 48th move and it's mate in 3.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's like
so unfortunate.
Yeah, and when I have, I think, some 3 minutes and it's like mate in 2, I'm just checking the moves whether I wrote everything properly, because
right.
I need to climb there now.
Absolutely.
And it came to some 1 minute. I climbed. I called arbiter, and he's like, yeah.
He agreed.
Yeah, he agreed. But this guy said, no, I don't agree. So they checked it with the Mandra and it's 50th move.
Okay. So there was no conflict in the end.
No conflict, yeah.
And so much drama.
So much drama. I was like, I played very worse, and I'm in very bad mood. And then even after the draw, I'm very sad because of the game I played.
Yeah. No,
okay,
no.
I'm so lucky.
No. You must always take all the luck that you can get.
Yeah,
your way.
You're right.
And today you have really turned your luck around. You've played beautifully.
Yes.
So congratulations, Krishna. It's very fun talking to you. I wish I can get another day and another day to talk to you.
Yeah, thank
in
you.
In that way, I'm basically wishing you luck.
Yeah.
That go ahead and beat all the players you meet.
Yeah, okay.
And again, yeah, all the best.
Thank you.
and do well. Thanks so much.
Thank you.